I'd like to talk a little bit more following on from the last video about doing all the work to manifest twin flame union. Is your twin flame doing anything at all? Are you doing everything while they're just wandering around, twiddling their thumbs? The truth is, if one twin is called to do the spiritual work, it's the other one that's actually carrying the heaviest burden. That's your man or woman there. They're taking it all on. What it is that your shared blocks have been moved over to your twin flame to free you up to be able to do the spiritual work, to free yourselves, to free you both from the illusion of separation. So your twin flame should be feeling pretty divine in your heart right now. That's the part of them you know, the divine in them. When you feel it in your heart, all the deeper places, ask the divine to guide you. Be with the divine everywhere. See the divine in your sock drawer. That's all part of your commitment to yourself, your commitment to your own femininity or masculinity. It's giving you what you need to feel safe. No more living in survival mode, but love is the mechanism that you want. That's the new foundation. So, as you strengthen your foundation of love that your union is going to stand solidly upon, you'll be able to surrender more and more the pattern of feeling anxious and nervous and wanting to know what exactly is coming. Just know that it's going to be good. Call more in safely. Nothing can harm your love. If you're still feeling little bits of doubt, if you've got little pockets of doubt that you're finding deep in deeper and deeper places, and they're coming up and alternating with the energy of knowing that it's all going to be okay, well, that's okay too. It's a process in itself. It can take many months to reveal a twin flame for who they truly are to you, or not, as the case may be. So, if this process is taking a little while, there's nothing to be afraid of. Both twins are going through this in unison right now. Greater peace and knowingness is the destination. There is only one man or one woman for you. They're real. You know they're real because you feel them in your heart, and you're not going to receive anything other than that. That's your man, that's your woman, the one in your heart. It's real, it's true. That's the divine speaking to you through your heart, the divine speaking to you through your feelings, and your feelings are good. Keep going deeper into trusting the divine here and even beyond harmonious union. Just keep going there, keep working it. It really doesn't matter how things look. If we got a pattern coming up that makes us still a little bit doubtful about committing to real love, it can be quite natural that we then find ourselves sitting in an in-between place, a between worlds place. And that can feel uncomfortable because we don't yet have the clarity to take the next step and fully see ourselves, fully receive ourselves. We need to keep working through it, and you work through it by staying present with your feelings and bringing love there. And that can mean spending time in a place that looks very different to the ideal. But that's okay because you're not staying there, you're just moving through it. If that's what it takes, so be it. Because if your twin flame is sitting in a place of in-betweenness, in their heart, they're clearly not committed where they are. Maybe if there's a karmic relationship, but they're working a process. A pattern will be being worked through with that situation. It could be a pattern of needing to understand what it would mean to fully commit their heart. There is a desire to do so, but until they're ready to do that fully, and that is the union part, they're going to still be moving through that in-between stage. And this in-between stage may include one's twin flame being in another relationship where they are settling for less, because you always are when it's not your twin flame. You'll know if you've experienced this kind of relationship yourself already. You'll understand that the safety that you were seeking in that settling for less relationship was not real safety. It was all a trap, an ego trap. Maybe a form of watered down love could have been present, but you would have been able to see the pattern present as well. And people rationalize it and justify it and make excuses to stay in a mediocre, less than ideal situation by telling themselves that it's better than what they've known before. Their heart might still not be fully satisfied. But there's benefits to be had of sorts, secondary benefits. Maybe very comfortable in this type of setup, but knowing it's not the real thing. When we call in love for real, we have blocks to love that come up because the blocks are the actual separation consciousness from the say it from the real safety and the real commitment. Know that the divine is all good and all the safety and the beauty. Every time you're not feeling that, remember it's all about your relationship with the divine everywhere. It's not the journey, but just basically getting clear as to whether or not we want a relationship that has within it the hell of separation or not. There's no need to worry about what other people think. If anyone was bothered about you having your good or didn't want you to have your good, they'll soon reveal themselves and leave your reality. Keep choosing what's best for you. Yeah, I touched a little bit on third-party karmic relationships a couple of minutes ago. I'm not going to get any deeper into it in this video, but if it's whetted your appetite for information on how to heal a third-party situation, this video here goes much, much deeper. Bye-bye.